Hello and welcome to another edition of Music Gazing. Today we're off to the countryside with one of the world's most beloved symphonies. Beethoven's Sixth Symphony, known as the Pastoral Symphony, it's a pioneering symphony in many, many, many ways. The length of it, the amount of movements, the way that it's constructed, make it a very special piece of music. Although Beethoven is always portrayed in paintings as a very, very grumpy person, he was not. He was a wonderful man who loved nature. He was seen often in the countryside where he would be walking around nature getting inspiration and writing many pieces outside in the small towns outside of Vienna. He loved nature for its calming qualities. He didn't like the bustle and hustle of the cities. And for that reason, he spent much of his time outside of Vienna writing music. One of them is this fantastic symphony, the Sixth, which it takes place all in the countryside. Although Beethoven was not the first one to write a piece inspired by nature, it's a very different piece from the ones that came before. If you remember, Antonio Vivaldi wrote 4 concerti for each of the seasons of the year, which is called the 4 seasons. And these violin concerti are little vignettes of features of each of the seasons: spring, summer, autumn, winter. However, Beethoven's Sixth Symphony actually has a story embedded in it. And even though when it has a painting of feelings for nature and for the different parts of nature where the symphony takes place, there's actually a story that happens. Something happens during this composition, and it's very tactile in the music. So this is considered one of the first programmatic pieces of music ever written. This symphony is very unusual in that it has 5 movements as opposed to the common 4 movements of the time. This makes it a very long symphony, taking about 40 or 45 minutes to play. And also, it's very unusual in which it has very lengthy subtitles for each of the movements, which help you take part in the story that Beethoven wrote within the music. The first movement of this symphony, it's all about the happy feelings one gets when you arrive to the countryside, when you see the fields after a long journey getting away from the city. The form that he uses is the very typical sonata allegro form that many other composers were using at the time. But you can tell by the way that he wrote that he was inspired by the music of shepherds, the music of the folks that live in the countryside. There's a lot of Bavarian, sometimes a Tiroler feel to the lines, to the composition, to these particular melodies that are embedded. Thank you. The second movement to me is a depiction of a rest by a small river, a brook, and it feels as if people have just had a very nice meal by the countryside, a nice picnic, and suddenly they are resting. They are taking a time to just lay down and just enjoy nature at its best. It has these very small swaying melodies that permeate the symphony, but it also has these moving 16th notes that are portraying the waves of this very little brook. You can actually hear the water rolling by the rocks in this symphony. Very, very, very clear. It's all over the symphony. This movement is particularly interesting because it actually has a lot of bird calls through it. So you can hear them as the melodies go by, you can hear these bird calls happening here and there. And especially in the very last minute of the symphony, he actually has cataloged each bird by name. If you look at the manuscript, you can actually see the names of each of the birds that the instruments are representing. The nightingale, the quail, and the cuckoo bird. And they're all there in the manuscript, which has survived, and it goes into the scores that you find nowadays. So the player knows exactly what to play. The third movement is in a typical scherzo speed, and although it's very typical at the beginning, in the middle of it you find a Ländler going in as the second theme of this symphony. It's fantastic. You can feel the shepherds are dancing in this very rustic style music, definitely inspired by the shepherds that Beethoven might have met in the outskirts of Vienna, or probably in mountains near Salzburg. Dancing gets interrupted by the ominous appearance of clouds in the cellos and the basses. Suddenly, the third movement comes to a halt and the fourth movement starts right away. Also, very uncommon. And you hear a rumble in the low basses until the storm explodes with the help of the timpani, who finally has begun to play. Hear the thunder going away. The timpani is playing very softly. The moving notes in the cello and basses are shorter, much, much softer. And finally, the flute transitions directly into the fifth movement without any stopping. The storm has gone and the sun has come out again. The fifth movement starts with this wonderfully common call from alt horns that you can hear first in the clarinet and then in the actual French horn, and then immediately leads into the string melody, a beautiful melody that says that we're so grateful that we survived the storm And we are so grateful that despite this storm, we are still out in the countryside enjoying all the beauty it has to offer. I hope you will enjoy listening to this wonderful representation of nature by Beethoven. This is one of my favorite symphonies, and as you listen to it, you can definitely take a journey into the beauty of nature. Thank you for watching.
Thank you.